Have 15 minutes specially for questionnaire later on after this, before we end up this with the concluding remarks. So and this session, since it's 3, so we'll have 25 minutes max for this session, sir. Dr. Askedkar, can we have 25 minutes for this
yeah, sure.
Session? Okay, thank you.
Hello, good afternoon all. This is a technical session, or what are the technical skills required. I will start off with my example first. I did a graduation from VRC Nagpur in 1992 and then ME from Walchand College. And I did my ME dissertation work at ARAI in the area of noise and vibration. That period, project duration was something around 6 months to 8 months. And what I learned in during that period in the area of noise and vibration, I am still sustaining in this area of noise and vibration, and I am working in this industry from last 25 years. So what is important is what you learn during your internship or the project. During our time in 1992, there was hardly a concept of internship or anything, but the project concept was there. So I think previous session, that was on the, what I say, interpersonal skills or internship. So I want to put up one point that suppose a student, when going for an internship for around 6 weeks or 7 weeks, or sometimes in third year they are having something around 3 to 6 months, can industry plan or give a training in such a way that he can plan? Because internship 6 weeks or 3 months, he can't learn lot of skills, technical skills or any other skills. So if during that period, if he plans for his further project, means during 6 months, 3 months, he should get a training on some technical aspect, technical skills, and he can get an idea what he can do in future, or what he wants to do during the BE project or something like that, and then go for the BE project in the same industry and continue, so that it's easy for the industry also and it's easy for the student also, so that he can complete a good project in BE and he can get a good job also based on that projects. So I want to ask, put up one question. First question, whether the technical skills are really important and how, and what exactly students can do. See, there are different disciplines. If you go to computer, there are different. He can say that he should know the basic programming, electronics. I don't think we are in India having the very small or little opportunity to work in basic electronics. Most of them are working in the what you can say field of either application or related to software work. Mechanical industry, okay. My era was everyone from mechanical industry shifted to a software industry. There are very few people, those who are still continuing in a core mechanical. As I am working in Kirloskar, I am in core mechanical area. So what a student need and how industry can help to give the training or the project so that he can develop the skills and continue in that area.
Sir, so we wished, like, if while having panel discussion, you can cover up like any particular skills which are required for, say, automotive sector, maybe civil engineering, IT sector, IT enabled services, particular skills which industry is looking at before taking up internship. So this could be specific, maybe electronics. So VLSI or embedded industries. So we understand this is an era of interdisciplinary skills, but still few essential skills, technical skills, if we are talk about, we can, you know, renewable energy. So like, what are the skill set required that can be, you know, you can discuss upon? Yes, sir, please.
I think I can start the ball rolling. My name is Vilas Rabade, and I have worked for Philips we say intertechnology, two-wheeler automotive electronics, in hardware part, and work with my own hands, and now acting as a consultant for many activities. First thing I would like to bluntly say that skills are necessary, skills are required. Because without skill, you cannot perform. As a country, we can never. I know electrical engineer first class with distinction during Diwali time. The lights were gone. He was in dark for 3 days because he could not get electrician, and the reason was the fuse was blown. See, that is the condition of all branches in our country. They can talk, they can make a nice PowerPoint presentation, but the skills they have never acquired. So most of the engineers in the country are barber without razor. Repeat, they are all barbers without razor. If they don't have razor, then they can't perform. And that's why we don't have any Nobel laureate. We don't have any fundamental research in the country. For example, Sir J.C. Bose invented the radio, not Marconi. Okay. He demonstrated the radio transmission. But after his invention, not a single soul in the country did anything in telecommunications. This country is the largest consumer of mobile phones. But nothing is produced in this country. Now, little bit backward integration has started, but that doesn't. Basic things we don't do. Even the plastic cover for this mobile phone is imported today. And you know all that our petroleum bill will exceed, electronic imports will exceed our petroleum bill by 2020. That's going to be a very, very bad situation for the country, in spite of having so many brains working abroad. So these skills need to be taught from the childhood. Let us start from this vacation. Ask your grandchildren to wash their own clothes, iron them. Okay, ask them to repair small gadgets at home. At least they should know how to open the bicycle and assemble it. Okay, somebody was talking to me, he is from NMV. In those days, they used to charge 5 rupees and the student used to learn how to repair clock, how to repair bicycle in the vacation. So this vacation you can start, you will find sea change in the students. I'll just give you one example because everybody can blame and talk many things on my input that I have shared. But we did experiment with VIT students about 15 years back. Few of us from industry went to the college and selected second year students from with random number, roll number 1, roll number 7, roll number 13, like that. So we were not knowing their skill set, nothing was known. So we brought them to electronic estate on Satara Road, asked them to assemble an electronic gadget which was available in the market, kit was available in the market, so they all brought the kit, assembled that gadget. And we tested that gadget from the quality and reliability angle, and each and every project failed miserably. I just took a drop test and drop it from 2 feet, the circuit stopped working. So quality and reliability aspect was taught to the students, and that's the reason it is still yet not taught, and most of the student project do not work on the examination day. They say, sir, kal chal raha tha, kya ho gaya pata nahi. So everybody must have experienced this. Then we taught them what is quality and reliability, what is good soldering, all the good practices. One of my friend told me in 10 days he can train a raw person to a workable person. Yes, he is right, 100% right. If they are trained properly, it can be done. So we did the same team, electronic estate. We taught them how to make soldering, how to wind a transformer, gave them the quality and reliability aspect. Basic things were taught in a week span. And again, we told them that go to the market, bring another kit and assemble. And we are going to test your project from that angle. And these students, they did that. And all the projects passed all the quality and reliability tests which were mentioned. So within 15 days, this exercise was 100% success. All the students really came to know what they should be doing in their life. They excel in their project when they entered third or fourth year, rather fourth year, and they got good marks. Unbelievably, all the 15 students are today out of country. They are all abroad. Okay, they are doing fine in their jobs, and whenever they come back, they say, we got job admission in the colleges because of our this project. And on that project, they got a good job, admission to the good college. This is a transformation we could do in 15 days. So skill sets are required. And if we start from the childhood, I am sure we will have Nobel laureates in this country. We will have new research in the country. And these youngsters, after 25 years, you will find India transforming. If we take step now, catch them young, you will find a sea change in their behavior, their performance. I am 100% sure, based on my experience, because today I conduct a lot of seminars in colleges for faculty as well as students. Energy storage, I recently conducted 2 seminars and taught them the basics and what market demands and where are the opportunities. Rather, supercapacitor as an energy storage was my subject, and people can really take career because the kind of growth that this product is demanding, India could be the best suitable place for that. So like that, we can take a topic and guide them in which area you can excel and acquire the skills. And that's the reason every student of the mechanical electrical engineering should have a toolkit at home. Every American have a garage. The day services will be expensive, if you call an electrician, and if when the day he will start charging you 1,000 rupees, you will start learning to do it at home. And why not we do this from at least our grandchildren and children? Probably we may be able to transform the country. Thank you.
Good afternoon, co-panelists and participants from different industries. First of all, thank you to Raisoni for inviting us here. I am Leena Deshpande. I work with Bharat Forge as HR person, and I am in the panel of technical skills, but HR people, as you know, they have good skills to manage the situation. I'm going to talk to you for 2 minutes about the skill development that we had done at Bharat Forge to cope up with Industry 4.0 challenge. And after that, as a company, what initiative we have taken to bridge up the gap, this technical skill gap, between industries and academia. And of course, then the skills that we expect from the students when they come to us as an interns. Bharat Forge, till 1991, it was medium scale kind of company, just 200 crore kind of company. After economic liberalization process, we started growing, brought in new technology from Germany, and we realized that we need to gear up for this transition. All the employees previously, they were from nearby community. The only qualification was they should be robust, they should be physically strong to work with forging industry as such. We have changed all those concepts because technology was changing, globalization process started. We acquired companies outside and we realized that this is the time for diversification, and we started collaborating with different educational institutes to train our people. We have developed leaders within the organization by collaborating with University of Warwick, UK. We have collaborated with BITS Pilani, with IIT Mumbai, and so many other educational institutes, and started training our employees first. And we all know that today, manufacturing sector is going through a great transition as such. There is paradigm shift as far as technology is concerned, and all large-scale industries, they have started talking in terms of fourth revolution, and that is Industry 4.0. Again, we have set up labs for Industry 4.0 because now we are into defense in aerospace and many other sectors, and started training our employees in the labs of Industry 4.0. Now, what do we expect from the students who come from different engineering colleges? Our intake, as far as interns are concerned, is 100. Then GETs are concerned, we take 160 GETs, and we definitely expect that students, they need to be aware of such kind of transition that is taking place in manufacturing sector. Because Industry 4.0 means Internet of Things, artificial intelligence, there will be manless shop floor, and probably we all know that the jobs in manufacturing sector, they are going to reduce, and skill levels, they are going to be different skill levels. Digitization that is taking place, so the students when they come to us, at least the basic things we expect that they should know. Many a times it is observed, even they can't hold a vernier caliper and measure anything, and it's a fact because I am an HR person, I have been dealing with the students since long years. Their general awareness is very, very poor. That they don't understand what kind of transitions they are taking place in manufacturing sector or in any other sector as such. So what is Internet of Things? What is artificial intelligence? Digitized manless shop floors means exactly what? And at least little awareness about such things besides core skills that we expect. Then how Bharat Forge is trying to help academia for this particular purpose? We have set up a program like Talent Pipeline, and that is, it is not just for the students but for the professors. We conduct 3 days residential training of the professors who teach in rural areas in engineering colleges, and they come to us, they get little orientation about the processes in Bharat Forge, or what is machining, what is forging, how do we apply certain things that are written in the books, and so professors are on the shop floor. After training the professors, we expect that they will transfer this particular information, little bit of knowledge that they have acquired, to the students, and then we select the students as GETs or as interns. The expectation is that professors, they will impart this knowledge. We also go to these colleges, we conduct lectures on soft skills as well as on technical skills, and when the students are on board, they are absolutely prepared as such. So I do agree that skills are important, and right from childhood we need to impart skills, but when we talk about gap between academia and industries, industries are equally responsible to help academia, and academia is also equally responsible to train our shop floor people who are guiding the students. Because shop floor people, they understand how to do it, but going through that project format, going through a certain particular format that is required, that definitely needs to be taught, or and that is the responsibility of academia. And my last point is, technology alone cannot make any miracle. Technical skills alone cannot make any miracle. They need to be driven by aware minds. They need to be driven by the brains of the people. So soft skills, which are covered in the previous session, I believe, attitudes, they play very important role, and particularly this generation is very sensitive about certain things. I get so many cases, madam, bahut insult ho gaya shop floor pe. I said, what happened? I got shouting from the superiors. I said, so what? No, even my parents never treated me like this. So little bit of tolerance, attitude, and very positive attitudes, why we are here, what things we need to learn, that passion, okay, in particular period I have to learn so many things, and innovative thinking. They need to think differently, then only we are going to pay attention, because it's a win-win kind of situation, or it's a mutually beneficial kind of relationship. So students, they also need to help industries, and industries, they also need to help academia to bridge up this gap, and just to see that how technical skills of these students, they can be enhanced. Thank you.
I will not eaten up much of time. I suppose the majority of points are covered by my both the colleagues, but I just wanted to divert your mind to something different. See, skills are always required, and I strongly believe skills are the products of a practice. The skills required to a different section of an industry. When a student is coming to us, he's totally raw. He even not even aware of his own interest. Normally what happens, if I am a mechanical stream people, I have a wish to work on a shop floor. If I have electronics, I have to work in a ENI section, something like that. So at starting point, they are not in a position to judge where they are the best. It is we people, industry people, need to judge them where we can put them a perfect slot. I often remember a normal technique used, art of a diamond cutting. See, we have a raw diamond, and if we want to add a value into that diamond, what we do? We cut edges to it. The people who cut edges to this diamond, they are the very professional people. Means they always get parallel to HP, perpendicular to VP with 45 degrees and all that, then it will add value. If we done a mistake at our first stroke, we can add value to that diamond, or we can make that diamond to a zero value. So it is we people at industry has an equal responsibility to judge a people. I'm 100% agree there has to be a basic attitudinal skill, a learnability or teachability, following to the instructions, agility, timeliness, adoption to a cultural change, interpersonal skills, that is altogether required. But before that, you need to have a passion to do that. And I suppose if both the things are in a proper manner to get into understand every well, I suppose this problem is very easy.
So to summarize or to say that it is necessary to have a basic interpersonal skills, communication skills, adaptability, and a technical skills. Most likely when a student goes for an internship or for a project, the company will guide him to learn the technical skills in that particular area. Recent, as I am working in Kirloskar from last 15 to 16 years, we used to have a lot of students for projects, that is for BE projects, ME projects. Previously, I used to have almost 5 to 6 batches of 4 students, that is around 20 students for BE doing BE projects and 5 or 6 students doing ME projects. Slowly, I have stopped taking the students. What is happening is, initially, student will do a project, a group of students. Afterwards, what is happening is, they were not showing any interest in doing the project, and it's the responsibility of the industry person or a guide that he has to complete his work. So I have to work overtime and do the project. Recently, what is happening is the students, okay, we are discussing, we are giving all the facilities to the students, but it's on him to learn and to grasp and to work. During our days, we used to work in the company up to 9:30, 12 o'clock, 10 o'clock, and we used to learn a lot of things. Now, after 6 o'clock, the student doesn't want to work. He wants to go because he is having some, want to go to gym or some movies or something. They are not ready to learn, first thing. Even during the academics, that is during this BE course, we used to refer the reference books. We knows the foreign authors. Kaun sa pustak se, kitab se kya karna hai. Now the students, when they are studying it on the mobile. I am facing this problem because my daughter is studying in second year mechanical. They are always going through the PPTs, that's all. They are not having or going through the basics of that particular subject. I don't know, man. It's a problem of academics, teachers, or it's the problem with a student. So what is happening is they are having only the, they are learning that subject only to score and to clear that subject. That's the attitude of the student. In after coming to the industry, they just want to complete the project. It's not that key, they will learn that particular. If I am a mechanical, so I will more speak about the mechanical engineering. Suppose doing a project in ANSYS or some measurement or these things, they will not learn how to apply the boundary conditions, what he will get. They will not do the DOE or optimization or anything. They will just complete the project and they want a certificate from the company that he did this project. They will print the thesis, go to submit it to the college and they will get a degree. When they will come to the company, the or even if you go for the interview, basic ask the for mechanical engineer, what is the frequency, what is the, what will happen if I increase the stiffness, simple formula 1 upon 2 pi under root k by m, any mechanical, even what we learned during ME, now the students are learning in graduate courses, that is final year, third year. So means whether we are compressing too much or overloading the students too much, that what we learn in first year, that is TOM 1, TOM 2, that is first, second, third, independent years, we are, what you can say, compressing entire syllabus in either one semester. So it's becoming overburdened. So they just want to, what you can say, go through and just clear the subject. I mean, that's so open debate, I don't know. But this is the fact what we are facing right now.
Before moderator throws it open for question and answer, I would like to add a little thing. National Skills Skill Council of India have been formed considering the importance of skill and requirement of the nation. And it's a really a good job government has initiated. I was involved 4 years back in this exercise because Pune is an automotive hub and Chakan especially is going to be a very premium automotive hub and lot of skill sets will be needed. And you can see today a lot of companies are there into automotive electronics as well as automotive precision spare parts. So they have written down the skills requirement in association with the industry. Suppose there is a electronic assembly machine and what kind of skill sets are required? They have written down to the last point that the skill set expected from a person. And they get trained in that particular profession. So I have brought few leaflets of this National Skill Council. Fortunately, they have a representative in Pune. So any industry, any academics, if they are interested, I can share these leaflets with you. Because since, not because of I am involved, but I could see the efforts taken by different industry people writing down the requirement for that particular skill are really done a very good job. And definitely if the industry or academics, they follow, our dream, what we are discussing today, may come through, come true. Thank you. Over to moderator.
So any questions?
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes. They will be sorry.
Over the
And then Karatkar, sir. Yes.
Sir, I just wanted to say that from the industry, we don't have to solve every problem. They can guide the industry decision makers or the leaders that, okay, don't go into this path. It is very difficult and we will not able to succeed. Only this is a path where we are going to grow or there is a chances of success. I think that is a decision making ability a person should have. I feel that is most important skill everyone should have and we should actually try to develop from the student's perspective. The another skill what I feel is being very clear about risks, what we are taking and then making those risks very clear to the panels who are making the decisions, including himself or herself who is a part of that project team. Many times what we realize that we don't talk about failures, we don't talk about issues, we just talk about what is that required to solve the problem. But really that problem may not be required to solve. We can just stop the project there itself without investing money and efforts. And why I say that is finally engineering is a social work, is not individual work, because all the functions of the organization comes together to solve the problem. Not only engineering, but it is purchasing, finance and marketing and all of them. I think that is also another skill, that how do we become a socialized in the organization?
Yeah, that's a good point. That is important, that the people, those who are experienced, they should share their experience, their failures and their success stories also.
I would like to answer your question partly, because with my experience, I worked in Philips with maintenance, automation, so many activities. And many times there is no problem, there is an imaginary problem. People think, those who do not touch the machine or those who do not operate, but their bosses, they say, aisa karega to nahi chalega ye. I said, you just go to the machine. I'll tell you one example. We brought one winding machine for capacitors from Holland and it was about to get installed. But suddenly the bosses said that ye to nahi chalne wala, this operation will not happen. I said, I am going to install the machine. Let's install and see the problem. No, you modify this tomorrow so that day after tomorrow I can start the production. So I said, coolly went to the shop floor, installed the machine, called the skilled operator, asked him, you load the foils and start winding. And within 15 minutes, operator got trained and he started, the winding has started. There was absolutely no problem because machine which was working in Holland for so many years do not need any modification. Their designers have already taken care. And I called the whole team that we were discussing this problem, just check up with this operator whether he is facing that problem. And operator told me, problem? What problem? There is no problem. So, we don't think, because we have not worked with your own hands and we cannot imagine the kind of problem. So first thing you decide, is there a problem? Whose problem it is and who can solve? If you answer this, probably you can reach the solution. Many times we design a machine with so many complications, like there is a technique called TRIZ, it's a Russian technique. Simple example, you all know, Americans invented a pen to write in the space with so many million dollar operation, and Russians, they just use a pencil. Okay, so this is a TRIZ example. Lot of operations in that machine for efficient working is not required. You just cut down. Suppose there is a lacquer dispensing, and if you are at the ground floor, you have to use a pump to pump that liquid. Just put it little height, through gravity you can give that liquid or whatever dispensing things. So many things, once you look from the different aspect at that machine, lot of things you can eliminate and make it more operational, because number of the eventualities are there, so many failures are likely to happen. So like that, if the approach is kept, a lot of problems can be solved. It requires more and more common sense, not engineering. Thank you.
Good afternoon. I want to ask the relevance of the skill development with our UG and PG programs. You might have studied the engineering also, UG, PG. And in UG, there are about 40 subjects, 40 courses. But it doesn't mean that the 40 skills can be developed. Okay, because the curriculum gives a stress on synthesis, analysis, concept development and all that. In our outcomes also, outcomes which are specified by the all in, NAC and all that, the only one or two outcome takes the care of skills. Otherwise, there are two out of 10 outcomes, 8 are devoted to some other issues. Okay, therefore, and our examination system also, we teach the subject, take the tests or do the practicals or small projects. But skill means doing the things in a better way, that I can understand. There is a very little scope for the skill development, and all 40 subjects, so let us assume that for 40 subjects there are 40 skills. But the student has the different differentiators. All the student cannot do excel in the soldering and all that. And some skills are inherent. For example, soldering is an inherent skill. I can groom that skill, but I should have the passion of that particular thing and some gifted ability for that. Okay. Now considering these issues, what is the relevance? And now the government policy says that they have started skill development universities and skill development. That is, they are also differentiating the engineering from the skill development. Okay. Now what is the job of the engineer? Analysis, synthesis, and what is the relevance of the skill development? Your comment. All can comment on this.
I can fully understand. Yes, whatever you say is required. But at the same time, skill, hand skill is most essential in any aspect. Whether you are in R&D, whether you are in maintenance, whatever. I always tell my students that at least acquire one skill in your life. but which will be unique. Okay, nobody should compete with you in that skill. For example, a cook in Vaishali restaurant, we all go to Vaishali restaurant, okay, for idli and dosa. There is a cook who just makes 3 times sambar, his salary is 60,000 rupees. He has to just prepare sambar in the morning, afternoon and in the evening. And he should not look into any other thing. Rest of the time he just relaxes. It is only because of the skill. Or onion cutter with bhelwala. You can see the kind of cutting he does. So if you acquire in engineering, these are all common skills I told you. But in engineering there are many skills, say alignment of mirrors in lasers. So many skills are there, especially medical electronics. Especially setting up the things, calibration of the medical electronics, because downtime you can't afford. Or even an aircraft. Okay, because when it lands, you have to quickly inspect and see that the flight is ready for the next flight. So such skills, if you are acquired, one skill you acquire in life, you do any engineering, chemical, mechanical, electrical, I can tell you nobody will compete as far as your wealth generation is concerned. Okay, and what you have mentioned, that 40 skill set, okay, you have a SWOT analysis of the person, what he can do or what he cannot do. Rather, I always believe what you cannot do. Just in school days we are taught that you, if you study hard, you also have a first number. It will never happen. First number will be gained by somebody who knows the trick of examination. After studying, everybody cannot reach the first number. That hard truth we came to know when we were adults. But if you focus on certain activity that you have a skill, there are tests now that people guide you that in which area you will excel, whether commerce, engineering, medicine. Does every parent want his son to go for medical or engineering? I know I am associated with one of the college. Because of parents' force, that boy came to engineering. Actually he wanted to become a photographer. And you will not believe, in first year, second semester, he created suicide in the hostel bathroom. And when we realized that it is because of, he was not allowed to study where he was interested. He could have excelled in photography, like 3D8 somebody was mentioning in the morning. So basically skill are required, which are missing in our country. We could not make a first car also perfect, first time right, Tata Indica. So many times failed, and it was a matter of laughter, because it just take out from the showroom and it failed. So many reasons. So we do not make anything first time right. Now thanks to ISRO, they are now mastered the art and we are launching the satellites. It is only because of consistency in skill and focus on the final aim. If that is done, I am sure, if we focus that, because what is their aim? To launch the satellite. Like Philips, we were making professional in Loy Lampen Fabriken, electric lamp manufacturing. We all did our development around that. We never jumped to Philips shipping. Have you heard Philips shipping? No. We worked in our core competence. So try to have analysis of yourself and SWOT analysis especially. And what you cannot do, please don't focus. Don't try to work in that area. Try to enhance the skill, the job that you can do. And you will have wonders, and you may be, even though you are an ordinary student, you can make wonders in life. I think I have answered your question partly.
Yeah.
I am a managing director of SSB Technocrats. This company which we have been launched from last month, actually this is a company which is a bridge between the R&D to production. So whatever things we are doing, so one thing we always find where is a process designing is one of the another skill which is required, where the engineers are required. And these engineers come from the different background. The process is not only electronics. It is a testing, it is a mechanical, it is a potting, it is a chemical. It is all over the mix. And entire setups is required for the electronic industry or any other industry. So my suggestion for this new student, there are some professional standards available, like 610D IPC. So some of the Indian standards is also available. So in this room, if you want to say what is a PPM level of dust and what is the standard for that. So these things are, when they enter into the organization, these kind of thing people are try to, they will ask you. So there are certain sets of standards are available, like IPC having so much data, and they have done a very good study, like a shoulder joint, how it should be. There is a graphical way, and some training is also available. So we can use this type of available professional curricular things, and we can help out those students also. So this is just my word to put on for the new things.
Okay. Well noted, sir. Anybody else wish to contribute? Yes.
आपण हे जे काय बोलतोय टेक्निकली स्टुडंट्सने प्रत्येक स्किलवरती डेव्हलप करायला पाहिजे आपल्याला सगळ्यात पहिल्यांदा फोकस करायला पाहिजे की जे पण आपण स्किल डेव्हलप करायचा प्रयत्न करतोय त्याच्यासाठी रिसोर्सेस म्हणजे मला एखाद्या पर्टिक्युलर सेन्सर्सवरती काम करायचं आहे तर त्याच्यासाठी जे काय अवेलेबल रिसोर्सेस आहेत ना ते आपण बीइंग कॉलेजेस बीइंग इंडस्ट्री ह्याचं एक कॉमन कुठेतरी प्लॅटफॉर्म केला पाहिजे की ज्या प्लॅटफॉर्ममधनं त्या स्टुडंट्सला त्या फॅकल्टीजला त्या इंडस्ट्रीला त्याचा उपयोग होईल की जो युनिव्हर्सली सगळ्यांसाठी कॉमन असेल कारण अशा टाईपचे सेटअप्स उभे करणं इंडिव्हिज्युअली इंडस्ट्रीलाही शक्य नाही आहे किंवा कॉलेजेसलाही शक्य नाही आहे पण जर का कुठे कॉमन प्लॅटफॉर्मवरती अशी जर काही डेव्हलपमेंट झाली की जे कॉमन रिसोर्सेस ऑल ओवर स्टुडंट्स आणि इंडस्ट्रीला अवेलेबल झाले तर ते कदाचित होऊ शकतील आज आहेत हे पण त्याच्या कॉस्ट आणि ह्या गोष्टी इझिली अफोर्डेबल नाही आहेत आत्ता
कॅन आय आन्सर दिस क्वेश्चन
सर
मराठीत पाहिजे का इंग्लिशमध्ये मराठी आय थिंक प्रश्न मराठीत विचारलाय म्हणून मराठीत सांगतो असे प्रयत्न पुण्यात चालू आहेत मी मराठा चेंबरचा 2 वर्ष इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कमिटीचा चेअरमन होतो आणि आम्ही ब्राऊनफील्ड क्लस्टर चालू केलेला आहे त्याला गव्हर्नमेंटचं अप्रुव्हल आलेलं आहे आणि भोसरीमध्ये 2,800 स्क्वेअर फुटाच्या जागेत आम्ही अद्ययावत लॅब उभी करतो आहे 50 कोटीचं गव्हर्नमेंटकडून ग्रांट आलेली आहे आणि 15% इंडस्ट्रीने गोळा करून त्यात टाकलेले आहेत लवकरच ती फॅसिलिटी अवेलेबल होईल ती मोठ्या SME साठी आहे ओके आणि त्याचं लवकरच इनॉग्रेशन होईल ह्या सगळ्या प्रोसेसमध्ये मी इन्वॉल्व्ह होतो महाराष्ट्रात 3 करायचे होते पुणे औरंगाबाद आणि मुंबई मुंबईचा होऊ शकला नाही पण पुणे आणि औरंगाबादचा झालेला आहे औरंगाबादकर पुण्यापेक्षा पुढे आहेत त्यांची बिल्डिंगही बांधून तयार आहे आणि त्यांची फॅसिलिटी आमच्या अगोदर चालू होईल दुसरं ह्याच्यात 50 कोटीचं सरकारचं इन्व्हॉल्वमेंट आहे आणि 15% इंडस्ट्रीचं कॉन्ट्रीब्युशन आहे दुसरी फॅसिलिटी पुण्यात मुक्तांगण सायन्स एक्सप्लोरेटरी आहे म्हणजे हे जे चाइल्ड इनोव्हेटर्स असतात काहीतरी शाळेत कल्पना येते की असं करून बघावं कारण ते रॉ असतात दे डू नॉट नो व्हॉट कॅन नॉट बी डन अशा लोकांसाठी ही फॅसिलिटी आहे 1 कोटीची इन्व्हेस्टमेंट झालेली आहे 50 कोटी भारतीय विद्याभवनने घातलेत 50 लाख भारतीय विद्यार्थी भवनने घातलेत 50 लाख गव्हर्नमेंटने घातलेत स्टेट ऑफ द आर्ट लॅब तयार झालेली आहे जशी विज्ञान आश्रम पाबळ आहे पाबळशी पण मी निगडीत आहे त्या ठिकाणी लेझर कटिंग आहे लेझर प्रिंटिंग आहे सर्व प्रकारच्या बेसिक इनोव्हेशन्स तुम्हाला ज्या करायच्या डोक्यात जी कल्पना येईल ती तिथं जायचं त्याचं इंजिनिअरिंग ड्रॉईंग तयार होईल त्यापासून सगळे प्रोटोटाईप तयार होतील आणि तुमच्या डोक्यातली कल्पना ही प्रत्यक्ष उतरवायला अनेक लोक मदतीला आहेत त्या ठिकाणी कारण तुमच्याकडे सगळ्या स्किलसेट नाही आहेत परंतु तुमची कल्पना ही कागदावरनं प्रत्यक्षात 3D प्रिंटरच्या सहाय्याने बनवून त्याचा प्रोटोटाईप तयार केला जाईल त्याच्यावरती तुम्ही काही काळ तुमच्या टेस्ट घेऊ शकता तुमची कल्पना खरोखरच बरोबर चालते की नाही बघू शकता काही तज्ज्ञांचा सल्ला घेऊन त्या कल्पनेमध्ये फेरफार करू शकता परंतु असं प्रोटोटाईप मॉडेलिंग करणं आता सहज शक्य आहे आणि ही सगळी फॅसिलिटी आत्ता प्रोफेशनली ऑपरेशनल आहे ज्यांना कोणाला इंटरेस्ट आहे त्यांनी मॉडेल कॉलनीमध्ये मुक्तांगण सायन्स सिक्युरिटीमध्ये गेलात तर ही फॅसिलिटी तुम्हाला आत्ता अवेलेबल आहे अनफॉर्च्युनेटली आपल्याकडचे लोकच जात नाहीत अशात काही आयडिया घेऊन आणि काही करायचं आहे का नाही तुम्ही म्हणताय ती खूप चांगली गोष्ट आहे परंतु असे इनोव्हेटिव्ह आणि जिद्दीने पेटलेले लोक यांची संख्या अजूनही खूपच रोडावलेली आहे
येस
तुम्ही जे म्हणतायत ते ॲग्रीड आहे मी या फॅसिलिटीज सगळ्या जणांच्या बघून आलो आहे बघून आल्यानंतर मी स्वतः एक फॅसिलिटी उभी केली की ज्या फॅसिलिटीजमध्ये ऑलमोस्ट 10 करोड मी इन्व्हेस्टमेंट केले पण इंडस्ट्री किंवा कुठलेही कॉलेजेस त्या गोष्टीसाठी यूज करायला तयार नाही आहेत
तुम्ही चांगल्या प्रकारे रेव्हेन्यू मॉडेल तयार केलं तर होईल ते म्हणजे त्या विषयावर पण नंतर बोलू परंतु ह्या लॅब आता तुम्ही जे प्रश्न विचारले त्याचं मी आता उत्तर दिलं दुसऱ्या प्रश्नाचं उत्तर आपण चर्चा केल्याशिवाय देता येणार नाही
ॲग्रीड मी तुम्हाला डिटेल्स पाठवतो
हॅलो गुड आफ्टरनून एव्हरीबडी माय सेल्फ GR Thakur representing Accurate Group of Companies related to this session we are proud that we are a part of this workout so I just wanted to inform that now we are working with this multi-skill and technical skills. As Accurate is one of the oldest manufacturing metrology and quality control company. After manufacturing and having a big supply to 650 plus companies as well as 28 countries, we are exporting our goods as well as CMM, which is a pioneer workout in manufacturing of automobile industries, in aerospace and railways also. But on that behalf, now we are having a shortfall of engineers, quality engineers. And so since last 8 to 10 years, we are working regarding to the same concept. And we are going with geometrical dimension and tolerances. This is the basic concept which we are working for, especially mechanical engineers. Because as it is known very well to everybody that the mechanical engineer's language on floor level is a engineering drawing. No one is ever going to tell him that what he has to do, what he has to maintain, what he has to check. But it is very much necessary for that engineer that he should know geometrical dimension and tolerances. Without that, he can't make any product. So nowadays, we at the Accurate group of companies, we are having a session of 2 days, 6 days, 15 days and 1 month also. We are working for fresh engineer students who are in third year and fourth years. As well as that, we are having a chain with most of the companies to whom we have supplied our CMM and other products. They are interested to take engineers from Accurate groups because the outsourcing which has been done by those companies to the small scale industries, in between the gap between inspection, is being totally weared off. And in that way, Accurate is playing a main role as we are having NABL labs and all checking systems we are having. So we are very much interested. For kind information, I'll tell you that we need these fresh engineers, and today we are with 2000 plus engineers, freshers, we are working all team. We are in Ranjanga, we are in SKF, we are in Bosch, we are in Endurance, and each year we are playing for this. And I kindly request everybody here, as we are connected to this session, we insist that each ever engineering college is requiring any such type of workouts, they can very frankly come and have a word with Accurate group of companies. We are ready to help them. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. So can we summarize? Yeah.
So to summarize finally, we need technical skills based on the stream wise, and we need interpersonal behavioral skills also. And important, it's on a student how eager he is to learn in that particular area. That's all.
With this, we have come up to the end of the program. We have a third set of awards and then concluding remarks. I would request Mr. Nagendra Singh to give away the appreciation to all the panelists, please. Kindly fill up your feedback form. Our volunteers are there. Please fill up the feedback form. That will help us to improve upon the program. The feedback forms are in your kit. So now it's time for third set of awards, and I'll like to again request to Tatia sir and our chief guest sir, please, third set of last set of awards, and then we'll request you to be there only for the group photo, and I'll request everybody to join us for the photo after third set of awards and this. Sir, I would like to invite Mr. Kaushik Banerjee, Red Hat Pune Associate Manager, to he is being awarded with GHR Awards for Excellence in Cyber Security. Mr. Kaushik, please. Mr. Kaushik is here. Okay. Next is none other than Mr. Kapil Vaidya, General Manager, Tata Motors. He is being awarded with GHR Awards for Energy Conservation. Congratulations, sir. He is alumni of IIT Madras and National University of Singapore. He has total 25 years of experience, 12 plus years of experience with Tata Motors, integrating latest technologies to the vehicles, hybrid vehicle, electric vehicle and fuel cell powered vehicle. He is also working with developing components that will enhance the features and drivability of the existing vehicle. Congratulations, sir. Mr. Nilesh Dhavle, Senior Manager, Vodafone, for GHR Awards for Best HR Policies. Congratulations. And he is involved with the software testing, lead manual and automation testing, having experience of around 11 years, currently working as a de facto manager in Vodafone. Congratulations. The next is Mr. Shiv Kumar S., Senior Manager, Volkswagen Private Limited, Pune, GHR Awards for Excellence in Automobile Design. Mr. Tulsiram Mudholkar, and he from Wipro, Product Project Manager, Wipro. He is being awarded with GHR Awards for Innovation Catalyst. 12 years of experience in software testing, functional testing experience in Agile Scrum, Certified Agile Coach and Certified Scrum Master, Scrum Alliance, SFC, Agile Certified Professional Mentor and Trainer, trained multiple Scrum Masters and 200 plus team members. Congratulations, sir. Mr. Yogesh Sable, WNS Global Services, Assistant Vice President. He is being awarded with GHR Awards for Excellence in Services. 15 years of rich experience in the field of engineering services. This award would be received by his wife, who is there. Who is our faculty as well. Last but not the least, the speaker of today, Head Contracts and Procurement, L&T Realty, Harishwaran Ariyar, with GHR Awards for Excellence in Construction Management. Congratulations, sir. Over 35 years of measured success in the areas of commercial operations, operation management, risk analysis, contract management, construction management, budget and cash flow management, supply chain management, talent management, analytics and digitization. A very good speaker with good humor. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. And I'll request two of you to sit over there so that request Mr. Dr. Nitin Kode to be here for concluding remarks and vote of thanks. And then request to everyone to join us for a group photograph here itself.